guys, welcome back to Vet Science. My name is Dari. In today's video, I will be talking about diet of domestic animals. I will share some tips on diets, why there are so many kinds of foods, tell you what I personally use for my cats, what brands I have tried, and I will leave links down below in the description of cat and dog foods that you could try. Most of us have read million things about healthy eating. A lot of people still think that diet is actually not eating this and that and whatever that guy told you not to eat. When diet or nutrition is the food a human or other organism consumes. Whether it's healthy or not depends on a lot of things. And it's not so different when it comes to animals. The food one animal should eat depends on a lot of things. The size of the animal, the activity of the animal, the age of the animal, whether the animal is healthy or not. It depends on whether the animal is neutered or not. And these are just some of the factors that can determine the frequency and the amount of food intake. A diet of a cat or a dog may consist in dry food or in wet canned food. Also, there are diets that consist in raw meat and bones, but I'm not going to get into that topic because there are different opinions on that. And right now we have plenty of things to discuss, so I'm going to leave that to another video. When it comes to dogs, their food does not consist on 100% protein. It has protein, fiber, carbohydrates, fat, while cat food is much more higher in protein, and the other parts like fat, fiber and carbohydrates are in lower level. I'm not gonna talk about the vitamins, minerals and other components of foods. We're not gonna get that much into detail. Okay, so let's get to the tips. Tip number one, trust the poop. Like I said before, I am extremely passionate when it comes to poop because poop is basically a pile of answers. If you give your pet low quality food, which is high in fiber, high in carbohydrates, has a lot of waste products that come from meat factories and not actual meat, then the poop, my friend, is going to be a lot and not in a good shape or texture. A lot of those nasty things are just passing through. They're not being absorbed by the organism. So feed a shit ton of food and you get twice as much poop. But if you give high quality food that is made of real meat, has a lot of protein, is balanced, which is very important, then what happens is you give a decent amount of food and you get a little bit of poop at the end. Why? Because everything passing through is being absorbed, all the good stuff, and there's basically not that much left. Tip number two, combine dry and wet food. Imagine if you only ate soup or you only ate steak. Wouldn't that be boring? So it's the same when it comes to your pets. What I personally do is I feed my cats mainly dry food, and once or twice a week I feed them wet food. One of my cats occasionally has a salad, but that's not because I'm making her eat that. She just likes green stuff like lettuce, spinach, cabbage, basically everything that makes that crunchy sound when you cut it. Tip number three, no human food. I shouldn't have to try to explain this. First of all, not giving your pet human food from your plate creates discipline. That means that it won't sit next to your chair and beg you for food while you're eating. And also, when you leave something at the table and you return, you won't see it gone. It's gonna stay there. Why? Because the dog or the cat knows that that is your food. And also, human food, a lot of salt, a lot of sweets, really, really processed, not meant for animals. Tip number four, do not forget the water. As we all know, water is extremely important. Cats, unlike dogs, don't drink that much water. But no matter how much water your pet drinks, try changing the water every single day. I personally use a Brita filter. This is not a sponsored video because tap water is so nasty. I hate tap water. So I don't want my cats to drink tap water. Also, I think that the Brita filter is not probably filtering it 100%, but at least it's getting rid of all those bigger particles that may be in the water. And I try to change the water every single day. I usually change it when I go to take a shower. Dang it, now you know I lied. I take showers only once a year. I try to change the water every time I walk in and walk out of the bathroom. Tip number five, keep dry food in a container. Keeps the food fresh and it's easy for you to use. Also, what I like to use is a measuring cup. You can get these from your clinic. If you buy a certain brand of food, for that specific brand, they have measuring cups on which are written the different kinds of foods we have for dogs measuring and we have for cats. Since I have cats, here for example are all the diet foods. Here it says urinary stress. So if you're using this type of food, you should measure on this scale. And on the package of the food, it says depending on the kilograms of your animal and age, what amount of food you should give. It'll probably say something like 75 grams per day, which means that you have to divide that in two if you feed your animals twice. Tip number six, keep canned food that is already opened in the fridge. Of course, that is absolutely logical. The thing here is that when you get it out of the fridge and you wanna pour some in the bowl, try not to give it right away to your animal. Animals tend to eat their food really, really fast. So if you give them cold food, they're just gonna swallow the cold food. That cold food is digested slowly. So leave the food on the table, let it get room temperature, and then give it to your dog or cat. Tip number seven, don't give your pets colorful food. Just imagine the chemicals they use to color that dry food, all those green, yellow, red, orange colors. And if you think that those are natural dyes, I think you're stupid. There's so many brands out there on the market that a lot of the times people have problems choosing which one they should use. Here are some things that can help you make a better choice. Number one, don't go for the cheap food. Cheap equals low quality equals tons of poop equals no nutritional value. And I'm talking about the cheap, the one they sell in the supermarket. Number two, try buying from your vet clinic. Usually in vet clinics, they have a section like a pet store where they sell quality food, and even the cheapest food there isn't that bad. Number three, look at the things written on the package. Just like you spend hours in the supermarket reading labels of what your food contains, you should do the same when it comes to your animal. A lot of the times clinics work with certain brands, but that doesn't mean they're not going to give you any other options if you ask them what would they recommend. So different foods serve different purposes. I divided these in three categories. The first one is veterinary diet or science diet or healing food. These kinds of foods are sold only in clinics and are prescribed by a doctor, and they should be used for a certain period of time. For example, 1 month. Category number two, diet food. This is the food that comes after the veterinary diet or the prescription diet, but it's also a food that you can use regularly. There are different types of diet food. For example, one can be for allergies, others can be for neutered cats, others for sensitive stomach, and the list goes on and on. And the last category are everyday foods, foods that you can give to your animal if it's healthy, and while giving the food you see no irregularities, the pet feels healthy. So these are all other kinds of foods that don't have any particular purpose. Okay, so it's time to share with you my personal favorite. I personally used Purina, Yocera, if you've heard of it, or Jocera, depending on the pronunciation. Also Gosby. And my two top favorites are Royal Canin and Hill's. This is Hill's if you have not seen the brand. There was a time my cats needed a veterinary diet or a prescription diet. One had urinary problems and the other one, I have just taken it from the streets. So who knows what she ate, and she just needed a strong diet, food full of good stuff, a food with high nutritional value. Currently, I give my cats Royal Canin Indoor, which is a food for cats that are inside, of course, that they don't have that much space to run, they're not that active, and they're also neutered. So I have to keep that in mind. They can easily gain weight. For example, one of my cats is a little bit overweight. Both of them eat the same amount of food, but cat number one runs all day while cat number two sleeps all day. So here's the difference. Another factor, activity, and one cat is fat and one is not. In my personal opinion, these brands are awesome. These foods are made to help your animal. If your pet has dental problems, if it has sensitive stomach, whatever health problems your animal might have, changing its diet will prevent problems in the future and will help its current condition. I know this video might turn out to be a little bit long, but this is a very serious topic, like a lot of the topics I discuss on my channel. Today, even though I shared a lot of information with you, I barely scratched the surface. Animal diet, animal nutrition is a whole other science, and I cannot simply fit all of that in a 5-minute video. Also, always consult with your vet before making any kinds of decision. Do not blindly trust anyone, especially someone on the internet. If your vet happens to agree with my opinion, that's fine. If he doesn't, that's also fine. If we all had the same opinion, the world would be a very boring place, and also we wouldn't learn anything from one another. Like I said, links are down below if you want to check out some of the foods I talked about. This isn't a brand video, I have to say that again. If you like my video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, hit the bell icon to be notified when I upload other videos. Don't forget to share my video. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram. Like always, take care of your beloved pets, and until next time, I wish you all the best. Bye.